Welcome to the channel Quick Math. In today's session, we are going to see what are simple equations of grade 7, chapter 4. Let us see what are equations first. If we know the introduction class, it will be easy for you to do the exercise. Now, let us go into these simple equations. What are simple equations? Before that, you have to know what is an equation. Now, let us take x plus 3. Here, I am taking x plus 3. It is not an equation. It is an expression. Now, let us take one more. X plus 7. These two are expressions. Now, I am using equals to sign to make it an equation. Now it becomes an equation. What is an equation? In an equation, there will be an equals to sign. An equation states that two expressions are equal. And in an equation, we have two sides. This is left hand side of equals to, and this will be the right hand side of equals to. We have two sides. One is left hand side, other one is right hand side. Now, the value of the expression on the left hand side is equals to the value of the expression on the right hand side. Now, let us see this with an example where we use the statements in order to make it an equation. Then a statement that is the sum of 3 times x and 11 is 32. So we have to convert this into an equation. So how? The sum of 3 times x. So first let us see 3 times x. 3 times x means 3 into x and 11. And 11. In the place of and, we have to use plus. 3 times of x and 11. That means we are adding 11 to 3 times of x. 11 is makes equals to and the number 32. 3 times x and 11 is 32. 3 into x plus 11 equals to 32. That is 3x plus 11 equals to 32. What we have done here, we have taken a statement and we take the expressions in that statement and we made it into an equation. So according to our definition of equation, an equation is a statement that makes the two expressions are equal. Let us see one more example. So we have written another equation. 1/4 of m is 3. So it is a statement. Now we have to make it into an equation. Let us see. 1/4 of m. 1/4 means 1 by 4. 1 by 4 of always represents multiplication. That is into and m. It's a variable. Is means equals to 3. 1/4 of m equals to 3. 1/4 of m equals to 3. So what we have done here? We have made the two expressions into an equation using the symbol equals to. In this way, we can use a statements to represent that the two expressions are equal. Now, let us see how to solve an equation. To solve an equation, we have three methods. One is trial and error method. And the next one is transposing method. And the other one is without transposing. So, you can solve an equation in these three methods. Or you can choose one of the methods to solve an equation. Suppose if in the question they have mentioned particular method, you have to use that method in order to solve that equation. Now, let us see how to solve the equations in trial and error method. So, let us solve it. Y minus 7 equals to 1. And in which method we have to do? We have to do it in trial and error method. Trial and error method is nothing but whatever the variable we have in the equation, we have to substitute numbers in order to make left hand side and right hand side equal. That means the value of the left hand side should be equal to the value of the right hand side. Now let us see, here we have the variable as y. So we have to take y and we have to substitute numbers until it makes the value to the right hand side. Let us take 1. And what is our equation? Y minus 7 equals to 1. Now, in the place of y, we have to substitute 1. 1 minus 7 gives minus 6, which is not equals to 1. So, try other number. Let us take y as 2. So, substituting this equation now, 2 minus 7 and it gives 2 minus 7 gives minus 5, which is not equals to 1. In the same way, let us check for the other y equals to 3. Now, what we have to do? We have to substitute in the equation y minus 7 equals to 1. So, in the place of y, I am substituting 3 minus 7, which gives 3 minus 7 gives minus 4. It is also not equals to 1. Now, and you have to continue it until you get the LHS and RHS values same. Now, I am taking y as 4. So, now substituting that 4 minus 7. So, 4 minus 7 gives minus 3. Minus 3 is not equals to 1. In this way, we have to substitute the values until we get our required RHS. Now, which value if you place here, it will be 1. We have to check it. So, if we take y as 8, we continue y as 8. So, 8 minus 7. 8 minus 7 gives 1. So, 1 is equals to 1. Now, our value, that is LHS side and RHS side, both are same. Now, our variable, that means the unknown value of this equation is 8. In this way, we can solve an equation using trial and error method, but always prefer simple things in order to solve an equation. Until the question they have mentioned, do the particular method, then use this method. In this way, we can perform trial and error method. Now, let us see with one more example. So, now, let us take an equation x plus 3 equals to 5. So, here, we have to find the value of x, that means the value of the unknown letter. So, here, x is a variable and 3 and 5 are constants. Now, we have to find x value here by using the trial and error method. Trial and error method is nothing but placing numbers according to our required value. So, now, instead of x, here, which number if you place, it will be equal to the value of the right-hand side. So, this is left-hand side and this is right-hand side. So, in the place of x, we have to substitute the numbers. So, start substituting the numbers. Here, I am taking x as 1 and I am checking whether it satisfies this condition or not. So, substituting that Express 3 should get 5. Now, x as 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 gives 4, which is not equals to 5. So, x equals to 1 will not be equal. Now, let us take the next number, that is x as 2. So, now substitute this in this equation. X plus 3 equals to 5. Now, in the place of x, we have to substitute 2. So, 2 plus 3, 2 plus 3 gives 5. 5 equals to 5. It satisfies our condition. That means the value of the right-hand side is equals to the value of the left-hand side. Now, the value of the variable is x equals to 2. In this way, we can solve equations by using trial and error method. Of course, this is a lengthy process, and do it whenever in the question they have mentioned particularly. Now, let us see how to solve equations in transposing method. Let's see what is transposing. Transposing is nothing but changing side. That means here, while you are solving an equation, we have two sides, that is left hand side, other one is right hand side, as we have already seen. Transposing means nothing but changing side. So here, while transposing a number, we change its sign also. Let us see it with example. So here I have taken an equation which is we have done in the trial and error method. Whatever method you have done, you will get the same answer. Now let us see it. Here, whenever you are doing transposing method, we have to change the side of the variables or the numbers. We have to get all the variables to one side, whether it will be the left hand side or right hand side. We have to get all the variables to one side and all the constants to one side. Constants are nothing but numbers. So all the variables to one side and all the constants to one side. That is nothing but the transposing a number. While you are transposing a number, the signs of the number also changes. Let us see the signs here. Suppose in the left hand side, if we have plus, while it transposes to the next side, it will become minus. Suppose if it is minus in the left hand side, it will become plus in the right hand side. While multiplication becomes division and the division becomes multiplication. Now let us see how it is getting transposed. So here I am changing all the constants to one side. So as we have already said, we have two sides, that is left hand side and the other one is right hand side. Now I am transposing the numbers to the right hand side, that is x equals to, while transposing this number to this side, the sign will be changes. Here we have plus and when it goes to the right hand side, it will become minus. So 5, it becomes minus, minus 3. So x equals to 2. In this way, we can solve equations using transposing method. While transposing, remember, we have to get all the variables to one side, all the constants to one side. That is your wish of getting which side, left hand side or right hand side. After that, you have to take the constants. While you are transposing the constants, you have to change the sign also for the constants when it is going to the other side. And then we know how to perform the operations plus, minus, into and divided by. After that, you will get the value for the unknown variables. Now, let us see it with one more example. So, here we have taken other equation, that is n plus 5 equals to 19. Now, we have to solve this equation using which method? Transposing method. Now, we are transposing all the constants to one side, all the variables to one side. Next, here we have two sides, that is left hand side and right hand side. Now I am transposing the constants to the right hand side. While I am transposing, the sign becomes minus. So n equals to 19, the plus becomes minus. 19 minus 5. So n equals to 19 minus 5 gives how much? Yes, it is 14. So n value is 14. In this way, we can solve an equation using transposing method. Here, we are seeing other method, that is without transposing method. We are using the same example so that you can find the differences between all the methods. Now, let us see how to solve this equation using without transposing method. Here we have the equation as x plus 3 equals to 5. So what we have to do? Here we are not changing any signs. Here we have to do the constants. We have to reduce the constants. So here, if you observe here, we have x plus 3. We have to take the opposite sign of this number and we have to apply to the both sides, that is left hand side and the right hand side. Let us see how to do it now. Here we have x plus 3. I am taking minus 3. Because here we have plus 3, so I am taking the opposite sign of the number. So minus 3 is which number you have taken, we have used in the left hand side, we have to use the same in the right hand side also. That is 5 minus 3. Now it gives x plus 0, which is 5 minus 3 gives 2. So our answer is x is 2. Here what we have done? We are reducing the constant in order to get our unknown variable. So first what we have done? Let us check the constants. You can do it in the left hand side or also in the right hand side. So here our constant in the left hand side is plus 3. I am taking the opposite sign of the number, that is minus 3. And which number you have taken, both sides you have to subtract with them. That means here we are subtracting minus 3 on both sides. So we have subtracted minus 3 on both sides. So if we subtracted minus 3 on the left hand side, it gives x plus 0 and 5 minus 3 gives 2. So x equals to 2. In this way, you can solve the equations without transposing method. Let us see one more example we have to do. Here, let us check the constant on the left hand side. This is left hand side and this is right hand side. Now, I am checking the constant on the left hand side. Here our constant is plus 5. So you have to take the opposite sign of the number, that is plus becomes minus. So minus 5. You have to subtract minus 5 on both the sides, that is LHS and RHS. So let us see. N plus 5. And what I am doing here? Here I am subtracting minus from minus 5 from both the sides. So minus 5. And here the number is 19 minus 5. Subtracting minus 5 from both sides. So 5 minus 5 becomes 0. So n plus 0 or minus 0, your choice. And 19 minus 5. 19 minus 5 becomes 14. So our n value is 4. Already we have done this example in transposing method. So here first what we have done, let us write the left hand side and right hand side and check the constants of the number. Now we are reducing the constants so that we get our unknown variable. Now take, here we have plus 5. So we are subtracting minus 5 from both the sides, that is left hand side and right hand side. So n 5 minus 5 becomes 0, n plus 0 equals to 14. So n value is 14. In this way, we can solve the equations in any method, that means trial and error method and transposing method and without transposing method. These are the three methods we use in order to solve an equation. It is your choice of selecting the methods, but in the question, if they mention particularly, you have to use that method. So now we can see the exercise problems one by one with all the different examples so that it will give clear idea for you to solve an equation. If you like the video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and let me know in the comment section whether the video is useful for you or not. Thank you for watching the video.